Hello students, today's class for your code demo session on inheritance. Fine, so here is the code. I am using the online C++ from tutorials point. Now this is the first demo for your inheritance class. So I named the very first class that is base. Okay, this name is can be varied, obviously. Anything, this name can be happens at A, B, C or anything else. Now this is a base class, and this class contain some data members and as well as some data functions. As you know, this name is same as the class name, this base. Okay, that's why it obviously the constructor of this class. Apart from this constructor, another class is another function, member function is there, that is you are seeing show data, and two data member are there, A and B. All are public section. Fine. Now this is our derived class. I named it as derived one, and it is publicly inheriting from base. Clear? So in this class, a member function is written in public section, that is our A is replaced by the X and B is replaced by the Y. Okay, now in the meantime, ignore this section, I will show you later. Now here is our main. What is this base OB1? So you know this kind of syntax already. This is the object creation. And what kind of object is created here? Base type. And we are calling some member function through this object OB1 show data. Clear? And here is another object, that is derived one. Clear? Derived one OB2 is named, and again it is using some member function, this OB2 change data. So change data is obviously a member function of this its own class here. And this show data, OB2 dot show data, so it is calling the member function of its what base class. Why? Because no show data kind named function is there, this show data is here. Fine. So here is your inheritance is working. Fine. Now here again object one, true object one, that is the base class object, we are calling the show data. Now at this point we are running it. So here is the result. What results? 10 and 20. Why 10 and 20? Very first just an object is created of base class here, that is OB1, and show data is called through object one, that is base class object, through base class object. Now this is show data, and what is this getting? Now since object is created, obviously the constructor will be run, and there that's why constructor place a 10 on A and 20 in B. So here if we print A and B, we are seeing 10 and 20. Clear? No problem. Now the second part, where the derived one object OB2, now change data is called with argument 30 and 45. Now 30 and 45 just replaced a and b will be replaced by this 30 and 45. Here is the result. And finally, again, it's just an experiment kind of thing. We are again calling the object 1, show data using object 1. Again, the constructor is here, and this constructor will get chanced, that's will be run. That's why again 10 and 20 is here. Fine. Now, some experiments let me done. Suppose in the previous class, I have told you that private members cannot be inherited at all in any point of view, either you privately inheriting or publicly inheriting. Okay, so that's why I put this all in public section of this base class. Now we can a simple experiment here. Suppose private these two data members are going to be private. Fine. Now let me execute. So some error already is given by the compiler. What are the errors? Int base A is private within this context. Fine. So line number 31, where is 31? This, whenever another class, this is the derived class, is going to replace A with its own value, it getting it cannot be allowed to replace it. Fine. So obviously the private members never can be inherited in another class. So if I want that some inheritance can be occurred, then obviously you should them place into public. Clear? So I am deleting it. Now next possibility, that I can privately inherit. Clear? Now what can be happened? Again some error is there, and this is on line 53. So let me go on 53. Now what is an error? OB2 is trying to access a data member show data from another class. Okay, show data, and since it is privately inherited in this class, so these member functions are in this private section. Okay, this show data is in private section, is now in private section of derived one. Now the private data members cannot be accessed through the object. That's why this is happening. But since its own this member function in public section, so no problem in this, in the above line 52. Now let me do a small change. Let me do it private. Fine. Now again execute. Some error list is increased, and look, 52. Okay. Till now 52 was okay, but now 52 is in error. Since it is again its private section and the private members are not be accessed through object of its own class even. Clear? So again going to it public, and this inheriting also as public. Now again execution, and it is finally again we are getting our results, that is 10 20 30 45, and again 10. Another experiment let me do. Suppose this base, it is constructor, so whenever you are creating an object, always this base will be executed, so these results, this 10 and 20 is happening. Now suppose I named it as get base. Data is taken, so void. So if now I execute, I will get some garbage value or zero. Fine, zero. No constructor is running, that's why no value is assigned to A or B. And whenever this change data with the values 30 and 40 is getting executed, then this is happening. So if now we are calling, it's using this get this. Clear? And okay, let me execute. Whenever or through object one, this get base, if this is an constructor, then it run automatically, no calling is required. But since it is now not, it is an ordinary member function, so we must have to call it. That's why through object OP1 of this base class, I am calling it 10 and 20. Here, now, okay, again, some constructor. So, this line is not anymore required. I can delete it. Okay, till now we are going through single inheritance, but a various type, privately or publicly. And now next type of inheritance will be demoed, like hierarchical inheritance. Okay, so remove this comment section. What was hierarchical inheritance? I told in the previous class that if a one base class is inherited by many more classes, then it is known as hierarchical inheritance. Clear? So now in this code, one base class this is, and two derived class, that is derived 1 and derived 2, both are inheriting publicly the base. Okay, now here another object 3 is created of the class, new class derived 2. fine. Now I can execute it. So let me explain the results. 10 20 30 40, already you know about all that. Okay, this is not required anymore. I can bypass it. Now it is 20 and 30. What is that? Is object 3 is an object of derived 2, of the class derived 2, and through this object we are accessing the data member A of base class. Fine, that is replacing by 20, and B is replaced by 30. So whenever I am show data is called, this 20 and 30 you can see. Let me again privately inherited by it. Now execute. Again some error is happened. You already shown just a few minutes ago that this member A and B is now in private section of this class derived to. Okay, so through the object we cannot handle this, but no problem with this class. Why? Because this inheritance is public. The OA is public, that's why. So it is the, now you can say, show again. Suppose A here in this class, it's nothing, you no use of this, just it is a picture or it is an example. So A2, let me do it A2, and it is private. Now execute. Again we are facing some error. Let me do it public. Some error will be gone, but still, because A2 is a private member of this class, and if it is a private member, it cannot be accessed through its object. Clear? This is not related with your inheritance, but the accessibility of private and public. So your singular inheritance and public inheritance is completed here, and obviously you should be careful about the code, because you have to code in your own machine as soon as possible, and prepare your lab copy also. Now we are going to our next example. Fine. So this is an example of multiple inheritance. What is multiple inheritance? Multiple inheritance is multiple base classes are there. So one class can inherit one or more classes, that is one or more base classes. So here we go. Two bases are there. Base 1, same as the previous example, we named something here 1 and 1 for member functions. Base 1, show data 1, base 1, clear. And base 2, so it is another class. And here some data, that is data member here A and B, so we named it CD. And base 2 and show data. Now class derived, this class is inheriting two classes, base 1 and base 2, both the way here is public. now since public, so all its public members, all of its public members will be inherited in the public section of derived one. So here is our main now, and in this derived class we are placing two member functions in public section. What are they? Change data, again the same as the previous example. New one is this, that is the multiply data. Multiply data, that is we are multiplying the data members and placing it in C and B. Now this is known picture again, that is base 1, this OB1, object 1, OB1 is the object of base 1 class, and this data, show data, is called through this object. So again in base 1 constructor put 10 and 20 to A and B, so here in results 10 and 20 can be shown. Now derived OB2, so OB2 is the object of our derived class. Now since it is inheriting two classes, that is base 1 and base 2, so it has now access on the on these four data members, that is A, B and C, D, and as well as four member functions, that is show data 1, show data 2, base 2 and base 1. Clear? And here we go, OB2 change data. So change data through 30 and 50 is called through OB2, and that's why this 30 and 50 is in our results, because this change data is executed. And another member function is there, multiply data. Again this multiply data is now called through this object OB2, so multiplication is done simply here. A and C multiplied, and it is put on C. So A and C means your, yeah, C means your 5, so 5 into 30. Now it is changed, change, and now 30 and 50, it is our A and B, fine. A and B is get changed in 30 and 50, and it will be multiplied with C and D, C and D for 5 and 6. So 5 into 30, that is 150, and 6 into 50, that is 300. Clear? Now suppose this can be inherited as private, and if we execute, then again we will face some error, that is show data 2 is inaccessible since it is privately inherited, show data. But show data 1 is no problem there, because it is publicly inherited. So again I am doing it public. And look, this object one OB2 dot show data 2, since we are calling show data 2, that's why we are getting the results of new C and D. This multiplication results are saved in C and D, so these results are getting. But if we call it show data 1, then execute, what is happening 30 and 50. Why? Because it is now just changed into A and B, 30 and 50. This multiply is done, but you are calling the short eta 1. Short eta 1 means A and B will be printed in the script short eta 1. This is short eta 1. So you are printing A and B, and here no change in A and B. So you are getting 30 and 50. So it is possible multiple inheritance, that is a class can be in a class can inherit more than one classes. So it was the example for multiple inheritance. Now it is for last example for your multi-level inheritance. So this is the code for multi-level inheritance. Now follow it. Again, this base class is same as the previous one. No change is made here. And this class derived one, again same as the your single inheritance example. And finally, this small addition is done in this level, class derived 2, public derived 1. In your hierarchical inheritance, this derived 2 publicly inherited from base, okay? But since it is multi-level inheritance, one by one, you know already what is multi-level inheritance. In the previous class I explained it. So first of all, this base class is derived into derived one, and this derived one in the next level is derived into derived two. Clear? Now how can I call it? This is again on the previous one, or the object of a base class, and it is using the member functions. And derived one object, already you know that in the previous example. So in the result 10 and 20, no confusion is there. 30 and 50, no confusion is there. Now this is the new portion, that is derived 2 object 3. Okay, this line can be deleted, it may confuse you. So here another object is created, OB3, from derived class. Okay, now this object, using this object we are accessing the class, the member functions of its base class, and again the base class of its derived class. Here this is OB3, A of OB3 is replaced by 20, and again OB3 of B is replaced by 30. So here change data, this line OB3.changeData, this is inherited just its previous base class. This derived 2, this derived 1 is the base class of this class. So change data is the member function of its base class, this object 3, OB3. And in this line, this A and B are inherited from the its base class of its base class. So it is a multi-level inheritance is showing its results. Hope you all are understood now all these examples, and this is your task to code to code and obviously prepare your lab copy for these four type of inheritance, that is single, multiple and hierarchical and multi-level. So this is the code demo session, part one of your code demo session. See you in the next class. Thank you.